Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can create email templates and email alerts. If you want to follow Salesforce training videos, you can search my name Sanjay Gupta on YouTube and you can follow my YouTube channel. So to create email templates in Quick Find, you need to search email templates. So you can select this option, classic email templates. So at right hand side, you can see various templates. Those are already provided or implemented by Salesforce are available. So you can use these pre-implemented templates, as well as you can create your own template. And here you can see several folders are available. So if you want to create new folder, you can click on this link so that you can create new folder and you can store your newly created templates in those folders as well. So I'm creating a new folder whose name is My Email Templates. So this will be its unique name, public folder access. So I'm giving read write access. And now here, if you want to add any existing email template to this folder, you can click on that email template and you can click on this add button. So this way an email template will be added. Then sharing thing is available. So you can choose any one option, like this folder is accessible by all users, hidden from all users, or you want to share this folder to a particular group of user or roles or subordinates, right? So right now I'm selecting accessible for all the users and clicking on save. So new folder is created and you can see one sample template is available here. Now I'm going to create new email template. So here various options are available. So I'm choosing first one. If you want to know how we can create an email template for HTML using classic letterhead, custom without using classic letterhead or Visual Code, so you can watch another videos on my channel. So this way you can see to select merge fields, these options are available. So if you want to put any field related to a particular object, so you can choose that also. So let me first type some message, then we will choose merge fields as well. So folder is by default selected. If you want to change the folder name, you can change that as well. Then available for use. So you need to enable this checkbox so that this email template will be available for use. Then email template name. So my first email template, right? Then encoding, you can choose. Description, you can write, this is my first email template. Now subject, this is my first email template for test, right? So here, let's say hi, then I'm putting a comma, then this is my very first email template creation, right? And thanks. So just after hi, I want to put a merge field. So from here, I'm selecting a contact. Then I need to select a field. So let's say name. So as I selected field as name, so this copy merge field value is already automatically created. So I am just copying it and I'm pasting it here, right? So whenever you will be using this email template, contact name will be available automatically here, and I'm clicking on save. Right, so this way our email template is created. Now If you want to test it, so you can click on this. So from here, you can click this and you can select a particular contact as well so that we can test the merge field. So I'm selecting this. So this contact will be merged with this email template and I'm clicking on OK. Now I'm opening my email. So in my email, you can see, hi, Jack Rogers. So the contact which I selected, that contact name is available here. And this is the message that I typed. So this way you can see this email template is working well. Then if you want to use this, while drafting any email, so you can also do that. So let's say I'm clicking on an employee, opening employee record. So in activity, we have a quick action that is related to email. So if you want to choose that email template, so you can click on this button, click on insert email. So here, you can select classic email templates. You can choose your folder. So here it is. You can choose it. So it is saying inserting this template will override the current email. So if you have typed anything, that will be erased. So you need to notice that. So here you can see contact name is not available because we are putting it on employee. So you need to draft email templates accordingly as per your objects. So this email template we are using on employee object. So contact related details will not be available here. So now if I open that email template again, so here you can see we merged contact.name field here. So now I'm editing it and I'm merging employee field here. So I'm searching for employee object and I'm putting employee name field here and saving this. Now I'm moving here, doing a refresh. So now I'm going to use this email template on employee record. So that employee name will be available. So I'm clicking on email. Clicking on this button so that I can insert. So here you can see recent use templates options are also available. So I'm selecting this one. So again, this is throwing this warning for overwriting. So I'm clicking on insert. So here you can see employee name is available here. So employee name field is containing this number. So it is available here. So this way you need to create email templates smartly as per the requirement of the object. So for a particular object, you need to create an email template so that merge fields can be available on that object records, right? So this is one use of email template. Now, if you want to use your email templates in workflows, process builders, or approval processes, so you need to create email alerts. And in those email alerts, you need to select a particular email template so that that can be used. So now I'm opening email alerts, clicking on continue. So here you can see, again, we can create folders. Here we can create views as per the requirement. And by clicking on this button, you can create new alert. So let's first read this information which is available here. So it says create an email alert to associate with one or more workflow rules, approval processes or entitlement processes, right? When changing an email alert, any modification will apply to all rules, approvals or entitlement processes associated with it. So if you want to use your email template in these workflow rules, approval processes or these process builder processes, so for that you need to create these email alerts and then you can use those email alerts while creating workflow rules or process builders. So now, description, we need to fill the name of, or you can see the description of the email alert. So test email alert, unique name, then we need to choose a particular object. So let's say I'm choosing employee. So it will work for employee object. Then we need to select an email template. So I'm selecting this one. Then most important thing is recipient type. So here we have various options, right? So user roles, related users, related contact, public groups, owner, email field, creator, case team, account owner. So you can choose any option as per your requirement. Let's say on a particular record, email field is available. So you can choose this. So on employee, this email field is not available. So for example, if I choose contact, so on contact email field, email fields are available on contact records. So that's why you can see here email field is available, right? So you can add this like this way, right? So again, I am selecting employee. So you can see email field is not available. So right now I'm selecting user and I'm selecting my name. And here you can put 5 different email addresses. So these are additional email addresses. So if you write any email address here, that will come into CC of that email. And this will become the 2 part of the email, right? Then from email addresses, so current user's email address. So this email will be sent from the current user's email address and to this recipient, right? So this way you can create email alerts. Now I'm clicking on save. So this email alert will be created and you can use this. Then you can see the related list rules using this email alert, approval processes using this email alert. So this way you can find where we have used this email alert. So I hope you understood how we can create email templates, how we can insert email templates while drafting emails, and how we can use email templates for creating email alerts for workflow rules, process builders, and approval processes. In my another videos, those are related to workflow rules and process builder, you will see how we can use these email alerts to send emails automatically. So that is related to process automation. So while creating records or while editing any record, we can send emails to users automatically with the help of process automation tools. So if you want to watch those videos, you can search my name Sanjay Gupta on YouTube so that you can follow Salesforce training videos. So I hope you understood whatever I demonstrated in this video. Thank you for watching this video.